Fitz Insurance Agency is the DBA of InSphere Insurance Solutions, Inc., licensed in all 50 states and D.C. Service and product availability varies by state. Agents may be compensated based on your enrollment.
Hi, this is Ron Sedgy, inviting you to join me for the Tonight Show of Radio every Saturday night, 9 to 11 Pacific Standard Time on CRN Digital Talk Radio. Now in our 24th year and well over 19,000 guests, the Ron Sedgy Show live originates from our Universal Radio Studios. Celebrities from TV, music, movies, literature, politics, and show business, at one time or another, they all come to the Ron Sedgy Show. So why don't you?
You can try fighting the law all you want, but the law is always going to win. From politicians and celebrities to sports figures and business leaders, they're fighting the law. Now, here to sort out the nation's top legal news stories is America's favorite legal analyst, Royal Oaks. This is the Royal Oaks Show.
Robbing people with a six-gun. I fought the law and the law one. I fought the law.
Thank you, Mike Horn, and welcome to the Royal Oaks Show, the fastest moving hour in radio. And boy, do we have a lot to talk about today. We are so fortunate that our millennial correspondent, Connor Oaks, made it, 45 seconds to go?
Millennials don't plan ahead. It's our defining feature.
I guess that's it. Now, there was some text about, you know, trucks and fires and all sorts of...
I was abducted by aliens.
Yeah. It couldn't be just an oversleep type thing.
No, definitely not. It's only 2 in the afternoon.
Ken Jeffries, our co-host, was here.
I was here early.
Neener. Yeah. Exactly right. So, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the show. You know, every Saturday at 3 p.m. Pacific, we tackle the big issues in law and politics and a little of the bizarre side of the law of the news as well. And new feature today, we're going to inaugurate the moron of the month candidacy. Now every week we're going to have a nominee.
Trump's going to rack it up every single hour.
The moron, not the blanking moron.
No, this is not a Tillerson thing. Yeah, this actually isn't a Trump Tillerson thing.
Okay.
It's just there's so many idiots in the news. I thought we'd, a little later in the show, we'd have a nominee. It's a little bit like, of course, Ken Jeffries over your day job for KABC. There's a drama queen of the month, I think.
They won a drama queen of the week. I forgot who won the. I didn't know.
It's a great idea.
Sometimes McIntyre wins it.
He's got nominees every few days or every week or so, and then they pick one. So we're going to get to that. But a lot of stuff to talk about. We're going to talk about Harvey Weinstein, of course. The plot thickens. And Ken Jeffries was just telling me that maybe he's got a creative defense, apparently maybe a contract clause that says, oh, you can't fire me for being a bad guy as long as I pay the gals off.
He could have won the Drama Queen of the Week award.
Absolutely. Yeah. We're going to talk about the Las Vegas tragedy still unfolding, the timelines changing, and Dianne Feinstein being in. But I wanted to kick it off with talking about Donald Trump because I'm worried about the guy. I mean, when he challenges his Secretary of State to an IQ test, and I think he's serious. I mean, I don't want to say Sarah Huckabee Sanders is lying when she said, oh, it was just a joke, folks. But, you know, it didn't sound like a joke, did you think?
No, that's not the sort of joke Trump makes. When Trump talks about the size of his hands, when Trump talks about his IQ, he actually is so deluded that he thinks he is as smart as the rest of us.
Well, is it a delusion or is it just combativeness? I mean, I think he's just Mr. Pugnacious.
Possible.
I think he's a counterpuncher about anything, about his wealth, about his hands, about his IQ.
Yep.
So when people are saying, oh, your Secretary of State called you a moron, I mean, he's got to strike back.
Yeah.
And by the way, Tillerson never denied that, which is interesting. It was almost like a non-denial denial or something like that, which was...
Exactly. Right. It was a very weird press conference where he comes out and he says, I love the president. He's incredible. It's such an honor to be part of the team. All these idiots making these charges. And then when they say, oh, Mr. Secretary, did you call Mr. President a moron? I don't dignify those
I
kinds
can
of charges.
Or deny. Right.
Well, he didn't go so far as to say, I can't deny, but he might as well have. Right. And then, of course, a day or two later, maybe it's the same day, a spokesperson for Tillerson came out and said, of course he didn't say that, but it wasn't Rex who denied it. It was the spokesperson.
This administration
when we come back, is the 25th Amendment going to kick in to remove Trump? Stay with us on the Royal Oak Show.
We'll be back on CRN with the Royal Oak Show.
You experiencing pain? Back pain, shoulder, elbow, or hand pain? Pain from a sports injury? If so, schedule a visit with Dr. Michael Sheps, the leading expert in laser therapy for pain management. Call 310-873-4422 or go to drsheps.com. Experience Epic T, the breakthrough laser therapy system that Dr. Sheps developed to make you pain-free in less time. Laser therapy is a non-invasive, safe, and effective in-office procedure that penetrates deep into your skin without damaging the tissue. It perfectly targets areas of pain to promote fast, natural healing. Relax your muscles, ease muscle spasms, joint stiffness, and arthritis pain while increasing blood circulation. For over 25 years, Dr. Sheps has helped Olympic athletes and sports enthusiasts alike get back in the game. Schedule your visit with Dr. Sheps at his Brentwood office in California. Call 310-873-4422 or visit drsheps.com. That's drsheps.com, 310-873-4422.
Welcome back to the Royal Oak Show with our co-host Ken Jeffries and our millennial correspondent Connor Oakes.
I'm tagging you in on this one.
So, yeah, you guys are you're just music experts, so yeah, I always like to run these bumper music songs by you. Turn up a little, Jose. See if these guys can guess what this is.
Oh, you don't know, Connor?
I got nothing.
Well, I'll tell you what. If you go your own way, you might be able to figure it out.
Okay.
That's a hint.
Yeah. The name of the song?
Go Your Own Way. It's Fleetwood Mac. And
got it.
I saw him at the Classic West months ago now at Dodger Stadium. By the way, speaking of Dodger Stadium, go Dodgers tonight, okay?
Absolutely.
Yeah. Even without Corey Seager, who's
Blue
on.
Crew.
Yeah, won't be,
Blue
won't
Crew.
Be on.
Connor, do not despair. We're going to fold a little more current music into the mix later. So you'll have a decent shot.
I need it.
Yeah, you know, it's not that I'm pessimistic about the Dodgers, Ken. It's just that, they have not actually been in the World Series since 1988. Okay, Ronald Reagan was president.
I was
when they last were in the World Series.
I was not.
He only had
fetus.
3 or 4 months to go, admittedly. But yeah, you were not born exactly. So isn't that a weird?
I was at the Kirk Gibson game when he hit it.
Oh, you were there.
Now I don't.
You weren't in the parking lot. That wasn't your red taillights.
No, we almost were. And my wife kept on saying, "Let's stay."
Yeah, good for her.
And the fat lady hasn't sung. She kept on saying the fat lady hasn't sung, and so we saw him hit it out. And
that was wonderful. Can you imagine how bad
it was? Great.
You'd still feel bad today if you had.
To this day.
Whenever I see the clip, I can't help but focus on the red taillights in the Dodger Stadium parking lot. How would those people feel?
Steve Edwards, the television personality here in Los Angeles, said he was one of those red taillights.
Was he? Oh,
yeah, if I remember that correctly.
No.
I did mention the story on the air years ago when I worked at KFWB here in L.A.
Right.
About that. We stayed for it and managed to see it, and it was great.
Well, I know we're digressing here, and I don't want to come across as bitter, but from the time I can remember, I've been a big Dodger fan, and I love the fact that they were good enough through the Sandy Koufax years and all the rest, Steve Garvey, that they would get into the Fall Classic. And in the 50s, they did, 53, 55, 56, and 59. In the 60s,
very good.
65 and 66.
Back to the Brooklyn Dodgers.
Okay, twice in the 60s, plus 63, they swept the Yankees. In the 70s, 74, 77, 78, didn't win, but they're in there. In the 80s, 81 and 88, they win both times. Fernando Mania, Kirk Gibson.
Right.
Oh, my gosh. What about the 90s? What about the 2000s? What about the teens? It has been coming up on 30 years. So I'm just saying, guys,
they still have a good shot, even without Corey Seager.
Or else.
There was a bad back for this.
Okay, here's the thing about Donald Trump and the 25th Amendment. And talk about baseball, it's inside baseball.
Yeah.
Everybody knows about impeachment. We went through the drama with Bill Clinton. The 25th Amendment says, if the cabinet and the vice president get together and say, oh, my gosh, this guy is bonkers. He's all over the moon, physical, mental, whatever. Mm-hmm. They can vote and they can say, you're out of there. We're going to just take a little time. The vice president becomes the president. If the president objects, he can say, oh, guys, do you have it wrong or what? Here's a letter that says I'm okay. Then he gets it. He gets the job back. Mm-hmm. But then if the cabinet and the VP say, nice try, we're still unconvinced, it goes to the Congress and two-thirds in each House, House and Senate, and he's out of there. So that's not impeachment. Oh, you committed some high crime or misdemeanor. No,
then what is it?
Well, just unfitness
for office. It's unfitness for office. And a lot of people are saying Donald Trump is the mental instability is becoming so palpable. Now, the answer to that is he's crazy like a fox. Richard Nixon told Henry Kissinger, you go negotiate with the North Vietnamese and the communist Chinese and so on, and you let them know I am a madman.
Yeah,
you have
good
no
cop,
idea.
Bad cop.
Exactly. And Ronald Reagan had the same thing. He had the cowboy image. And some people say that was in part responsible for bringing down the Soviet Union because they said, oh, my God, Reagan is a crazy cowboy. If he gets Star Wars up, he's going to kill us. We've got to bankrupt ourselves trying to build our own Star Wars. And it all worked out well. So what do you think? Maybe Trump's crazy like a fox?
That would require the wit of the fox, and there's no indication. It's not like he started his foreign policy 35 years ago when he was being a blabbermouth in the newspapers of New York, and then when he was a reality TV star.
He was always a blabbermouth. He was always, trust me, as a New York, as an ex-New Yorker, I know.
Absolutely.
I mean, he was always
a public fool, and he continued.
But it works for him. He's a winner. He's a multi-billionaire. I mean,
well,
doesn't that make him crazy like a rich fox?
He's a multi-time bankrupt victim who has crashed
over. He exploited the bankruptcy laws, okay, but the fact is he's a huge financial success.
But we can't say that it's all part of his strategy that he's a crazy person, because he's been a crazy person his whole life, and he hasn't been planning this since he was a teenager.
Yeah, the problem is he seems to make up foreign policy as he goes along.
Absolutely.
His detractors would say.
Yeah.
And the Iran deal is the perfect example of this. The Iran deal that he's currently trying to ditch, just like he tried to ditch TPP, just like he's claiming he's going to ditch NAFTA, just like he's claiming he's going to ditch NATO. His idea, his attitude is these international agreements and anything that happened before I got into office doesn't matter. It's not binding. It's irrelevant. I'm going to forge my own path. I'm going to change everything. And that presents a massive impediment for his own negotiations and even future negotiations. People are going to be hesitant to negotiate with the United States and to sign these agreements and to bind themselves when they think, well, the next president's just going to come in and say, that was Obama's fault. I'm not doing that.
And he, of course, is, from what observers would say, that he's determined to obliterate any mention of Obama, that even Obama was president, because he's trying to obliterate Obamacare by executive order, the same thing that he blasted Obama doing years ago.
He's doing
by executive order.
Now, his answer is he'll say that Obama's executive orders were illegal, and so it's okay for him to unwind them. But the bottom line is it is going to really devastate Obamacare, and then the big challenge is will the progressives be able to say, well, we told you single payer all along was best. We gave Obamacare a try. Now the only thing we can do is have Medicare for all. Yeah. Or will the Republicans prevail and say, no, we're going to tinker, we're going to repeal and replace. And so far the Republicans don't seem very adept at accomplishing
that. Well, they're also at war with Trump.
And that's
a problem. Senator Corker, now he's fighting with Corker, who's a major Republican senator.
Calling him Little Bob, because apparently, according to the press, he's 5'7", and so Trump is making fun of his height, like he's talking about his intelligence.
Like
Tillerson.
Little Marco, he did that during the
same deal. And you know, it gets back to my point about it's possible he's both crazy like a fox and crazy.
Actual crazy.
I mean, he is so unpresidential. We are so used to everything being choreographed and so scripted. I mean, presidential flatulence is planned.
We went from no drama Obama to this.
Yeah. No,
I mean,
exactly
it was like,
right.
Whoa, but you knew what you were getting.
Yeah.
This is what I don't understand.
Yeah.
You knew this. It was like an old super chicken joke, you know, from the TV. You knew that this job was dangerous when you took it. For the voters, I'd like to tell something. Observers would say, you knew about this guy.
Yeah.
He's doing what he said he was going to do. Yeah. Surprise?
And it's so disorienting, though, because we are used to a president behaving in a certain way with a certain level of dignity, regardless of the political stripes, formality. You know, you don't communicate unless it goes through channels. Here, it's almost like It's like a father figure. We're used to Jim Anderson from Father Knows Best. You know, he comes home, he's selling insurance. How'd you do today, yeah. kitten? That's Dad. All of a sudden, what if Dad came home and he was Charlie Sheen? Okay? He's sleeping with strippers, and he's snorting coke, and he's screaming about being a winner,
right.
and that's what we've got with Donald Trump. Yeah. It's like cognitive dissonance. There's the presidency, and there's Donald Trump, and it's freaking people out. I don't know if it's going to freak them out to the point where the 25th Amendment is going to come into play. Hey, when we come back, we're going to talk about Mr. Harvey Weinstein. I have missed some of the headlines. I think he's in a little trouble here. So,
hot water.
Well, yeah, we'll have to talk about that here on the Royal Oak Show. Stay with us.
We'll be back on CRN with the Royal Oak Show.
Located in the heart of Maui's premier resort, Kaanapali Beach Hotel is officially recognized as Hawaii's most Hawaiian hotel and the number one best value in Hawaii. With a range of accommodations and affordable dining options, this is the ideal setting to turn Hawaiian dreams into lifelong memories. Live Hawaiian entertainment every evening, free year-round children's programs, weekly arts and crafts fairs, welcome breakfast, and departure kukui lei ceremonies add to the value. Swim in the whale-shaped pool, indulge in the fabulous spa and hotel salon. Enjoy Hawaiian hospitality at its best at the Kaanapali Beach Hotel. Call 800-262-8450 or go to kbhmaui.com. That's kbhmaui.com. Aloha.
The smartest way for you to get the lowest prices on your plane tickets, domestic or international, is to call SmartFares, first or last, but you've got to call us before you book your plane tickets. Fly anywhere in the world, fly anywhere in the U.S., and SmartFares can save you up to 75% on your plane tickets. We have the lowest airline ticket prices on over 500 airlines, and you've got a great 12-hour free cancellation window. Plus, with our live agent help, you can always get fast help and fast answers. So on your next trip, maybe today, maybe tomorrow, how about right now? Pick up your phone and call SmartFares. Plus, save up to 75% on your plane reservation. So call right now. 800-915-2644. 800-915-2644. 800-915-2644. 800-915-2644.
Come to Angelo's and Vinci's to see the memorabilia of movie stars and theatrical magic right in downtown Fullerton, California. See the Art of the Masters, an Italian town square complete with storefronts of old Italian butchers and cheesemongers, fruit and wine vendors, seamstresses showing their wares, fairy lights from cathedral ceilings, and our ancestors smiling down at you from the family love altar. The Romance of Romeo and Juliet, and find the mystical Room of the Moon. And don't forget King Kong, Dracula, Frankenstein, and who knows what awaits you in the wine cellar. Enjoy the great food. We hand-stuff our pastas, roll each and every tortellini, bake our own bread, make our own sauces fresh from our private stock of Sicilian family recipes. From pasta to seafood, chicken to award-winning pizzas, tiramisu flown in from Rome. If you can't find something on our menu to tempt you, you don't like Italian food. Try our Sunday brunch, just $18.95, and Angelo's and Vinci's has been named 2 years in a row Best Italian Restaurant in Orange County. Angelo's and Vinci's Restaurant, 550 North Harbor Boulevard in Fullerton, California. Call 714-879-4020.
But myself I can't deceive. I know it's only make-believe.
Welcome back to the Royal Oak Show. Let's keep this going, Jose. This is a classic. I want to say this is 1958.
Some newer stuff.
We're going to get to the millennial stuff a little later.
I have a guess.
This is 1958-ish. This is his biggest hit. He had a long career, decades, at or near the top of the genre.
It's not Elvis.
No, yeah, it's not Elvis.
But I know. I think I know the song.
Give it a little more listen here. It's only make believe.
It's only make believe is the title.
Yeah. Conway Twitty, guys. I am so shocked.
You're right.
Conway's great great grandfather.
Well, she's not that young, and he's not that old.
Who?
Or whatever. Yeah.
He was a rock and roll star first, and then he became a country star.
You know, I was thinking about this.
The reverse Taylor Swift.
This is the weird. This is the weirdest thing, guys. I was watching a rerun of Family Guy, one of the best shows ever. And all of a sudden,
you like Family Guy?
Peter Griffin makes some comment about how, we got to distract people from what's going on here. Yeah. And they cut to Conway Twitty.
Right.
Singing this song with his weird hair in a...
It wasn't a cartoon. It was live. It was live. Yeah, it looked like a live thing. I remember that episode.
And it was the whole freaking song.
It was very funny.
So I thought, my gosh, we got to get this
That might have been my least favorite episode of Family Guy.
One thing about Family Guy.
But you sort of remember it?
I saw it today on DVR, and I was watching Family Guy, and they do all these little side things.
Vignettes,
like this show.
Yeah.
It's kind of like, did they go off the reservation?
So Peter Griffin, speaking of Peter Griffin, have we ever actually seen him Harvey Weinstein in the same room? I think they could be the same guy.
Oh, boy.
Sure.
Harvey Weinstein looks a lot like Peter Griffin to me.
Seth MacFarlane, the creator, said a nasty joke about Harvey Weinstein,
and they
played it on TV
during
the Oscar nomination several years ago, and he said something to the effect, and they named the best actresses, and he said, and these ladies now will no longer have to pretend to like Harvey Weinstein.
Yeah. Yes.
And that joke was said, that was not really a joke.
Right, and they've been playing that video in the last week or two, you're absolutely right, as evidence that it was an open secret in Hollywood.
I probably the early 2000s on 30 Rock, Jenna Maroney makes a joke about how she says, I have self-respect, basically. I've turned down sex with Harvey Weinstein three times out of five.
That's right. That was a great line. All right. So the plot thickens.
Yeah.
Apparently three women say he raped them. Now, who knows about the credibility issue?
That could be
we have
a problem.
No idea about statutes of limitations on civil matters, criminal matters in New York and California.
Yeah.
But it's a whole mess of trouble.
Mm-hmm.
And I guess the idea is maybe the Weinstein Company will dissolve. Maybe it will be bought by somebody. Something about Harvey going for rehab someplace. I heard Switzerland, and I'm thinking, oh my God.
Well, now he's in Arizona. He never made it there. Apparently, he's in Arizona someplace, right?
Mm. Well, that's what happened. You get on the plane, and they decide to stop in Phoenix instead of going to all the way to Switzerland.
I figured by the time he gets to Phoenix, it'll be.
That's right. Get Glenn Campbell.
He tried to force his way into the cockpit, and the pilots.
Is it the case here that he is going through some sort of rehab? Is that the idea?
Well, everybody tries to go to rehab when they're accused of something like this, horrific. And
well,
he hired
a big-time PR company, too.
Yeah,
O.J. didn't go to killing rehab when they accused him of crime. So it's not everybody.
He was already in a box.
What is this PR? This PR firm, it starts with an S, and I think it's Citric and Company, I think is the name of the rehab, the PR firm.
Yes.
And I understand they're pretty, I went to their website, and they're pretty big. And
it's
they retain, an L.A. Time, a former L.A. Times entertainment writer is I guess, going to be in charge of the PR, Sally Hoffmeister.
How can they dig out of the PR hole? I mean, the world has been convinced. I mean, when you have super high profile people like Angelina Jolie and Gwyneth Paltrow, not exactly, they're not super right wingers who are trying to take down some kind of progressive guy. Meryl Streep made comments about him.
Jane Fonda finally said
Jane Fonda. Yeah. I mean, I don't think anybody has any doubt about it. Now, before we went on the air, Ken, you were saying something interesting. I don't know if it's definitive here, but apparently there may be some clause in a Harvey Weinstein contract
according
with the company.
Let me hang it on TMZ.
They're always right. They break every story.
Yeah, TMZ is very correct on this stuff. So
we used to say about the National Enquirer, and now we're saying it about TMZ.
But TMZ is different. TMZ uses, I think, not to defend Harvey, I'm a lawyer, Harvey Levin.
Harvey Levin.
But he does his homework, and they have sources, they're correct.
He's an eight ball. He shakes it sometimes.
So no, if they say they were the first to break the Michael Jackson is dead thing and all of that, and so they were correct, that could be a and they said there were things in Harvey Weinstein's contract, I think, with the Weinstein Company, that to say as long as he paid back the women or something like that did bad things to then he can keep his job or something like that.
What that's going to amount to is he might get a big check somehow out of this, which will just hurt his PR. Hurt his image. It's not like the guy's hurting for money.
He's hurting for image.
Trying to extort money out of this company for how bad a guy he was.
That's
on the way
a load
out.
Of crap. How can a person have a contract clause that says as long as I pay off all the sexual harassment,
liability,
you can't fire me? Give me a break.
Yeah,
that's idiotic. When we come back, a lady that he has not harassed, Dianne Feinstein, wants to stay in the Senate.
So
she's 90.
We'll be back on CRN with the Royal Oak Show.
Hey, Lorraine, do you realize that your mother, my mother-in-law, Chef Maria, has been serving Las Vegas since 1949?
Yes, I do, Dennis. That's when she first met Howard Hughes, who fell in love with her cooking.
And in 1955, she opened her first restaurant on Fremont Street.
Yes, dear. And another great customer was Liberace.
Wow. Then in 1962, while Frank Sinatra and the Rat Pack were causing global excitement on the Las Vegas Strip, your family opened their second restaurant.
And in 1972, Elvis Presley began electrifying Las Vegas audiences and eating in our restaurant.
You know, Lorraine, this is quite a town. There's only one Las Vegas.
And there's only one Bootlegger Italian Bistro.
Folks, when you're in Las Vegas, come visit us. We'll make you feel like you're part of our family.
The Bootlegger Italian Bistro, conveniently located at 7700 Las Vegas Boulevard, South Strip. Visit our website at www.bootleggerlasvegas.com.
Hey there. Did you know that with a bachelor's degree, on average, you could make almost twice as much over a lifetime than a person with just a high school diploma? It's true. According to the 2012 U.S. Census Bureau, college grads with a bachelor's degree make almost twice as much as high school grads. Now, going back to school is easier than ever at Independence University. Log on and complete coursework from the park, or the beach, or even your couch watching the kids. And Independence University gives you the tools, a free tablet and laptop, for undergrad students to use and keep when they graduate. That's right. Get a laptop so you can go to college from anywhere. Take the first step to a new career in business, information technology, healthcare, or graphic arts. Call to find the online degree program that's right for you, and you could be on your way to increasing your earning potential.
800-989-1361. 800-989-1361. That's 800-989-1361.
You order a glass of your favorite Cabernet, fresh asparagus, hollandaise on the side, a filet, medium rare. You unfurl your napkin with a flair, close your eyes, and prepare to listen. Ah, there it is. The sweet music you long to hear. The sizzle. The sizzle of a Ruth's Chris steak.
The most magnificent corn-fed prime beef, broiled to perfection at 1,800 degrees. Some call it a sizzle. We call it an anthem.
As the waiter approaches, you think, is this one mine or that one?
Ruth's Chris Steakhouse. Like Ruth always said, life's too short to eat anywhere else.
Make a reservation online at RuthsChris.com or by calling 800-544-0808.
The following message is brought to you by Health Markets, your first choice when you need health insurance for your small business. Do you offer health insurance to your employees? Call us now and see if you can save money. Do you want to offer vision and dental to your employees? Call us. Do you think you're paying too much for your current health insurance? Call us. Do you want somebody else to do all the legwork and search thousands of health plans from over 180 health insurance companies nationwide? Call us. We're Health Markets, and thanks to a little-known solution, we could help your business save thousands of dollars on health insurance costs and save your employees money, too. Our service is free. Don't miss the great savings. Call now.
800-997-0151. 800-997-0151. 800-997-0151. That's 800-997-0151.
Health Markets Insurance Agency is DBA of InSphere Insurance Solutions, Inc. Licensed in all states. Product availability varies.
Welcome back to the Royal Oak Show, and okay, maybe this bumper music isn't exactly millennial-worthy, but it's a little more modern than Conway Twitty's only make-believe,
yeah.
Okay? So give me a little credit, Conway. We're here with Ken Jeffries, our co-host, and Connor Oakes, our millennial correspondent, so this bumper music is kind of familiar, I bet, to Ken. You have any idea, though, Connor?
I think I know.
I think I got the title. I think it's Good Vibrations?
No, you're talking, are the Beach Boys.
Yeah. I think it's.
You need to go back to the archives.
I think it is something probably out of the 70s, I think. Is it Jay Giles Band?
Jay Giles Band, right.
And I think it's. Is it called Replay? I want to say the song's called Replay, but I'm not sure if it is or not.
Freeze Frame.
Oh, Freeze Frame. Freeze Frame. Well, it sounded like Replay, but it was Jay Giles Band.
Exactly. Wow. Right. So, We're going to talk about Dianne Feinstein here, but I just to polish off on Harvey Weinstein, I guess it's just proof that no side of the political spectrum has a monopoly on harassment. I mean, everybody's been beaten up on Ailes and O'Reilly, you know, but now Harvey Weinstein.
I don't think it's the absolute opposite
of the political spectrum.
Right. I think it's got nothing to do with politics. Yeah. It's all about power. I mean, I think it is. Yeah. I mean, and it's nothing to do about sex. It's all about power.
Yeah.
Because.
But
that's,
it's also an inability.
Is that what rape is, or sexual assault, power?
Yeah, and it's an inability to control yourself. It's one thing to lust for power, but if you're a semi-normal person, as much as you love it and have the opportunity to get it and maybe had it and want to keep it, like Anthony Weiner, he couldn't stop himself. And I think Harvey can't stop himself either.
I see that as an excuse.
I see
these people probably are able to control themselves, but they're just bad people and don't. I mean, that's a maybe splitting hairs,
but,
right? We're really trying to define who's the bad guy and who's
at
fault.
Yeah, but Harvey, the problem
with it's not the victims that are at fault, it's these guys.
Harvey Weinstein wields real power in Hollywood, or he did up until last week, and Anthony Weiner didn't anymore.
Right.
And there's nothing, you know, with the people that he sexted, I don't think he had any power over them. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe he just wanted to get his jollies doing that stuff.
Yeah.
But Harvey Weinstein did have real power in Hollywood, and he could make and break careers, at least I think so, and I think he said so.
Right.
I can make you, maybe not in so many words, but he, on that wire that he wore that the NYPD, that was in the Esquire story, that was released to the media, the wire that he wore in front of this actress went to him, and she set him up, really. She said, "You touched my breast yesterday." Remember that?
It's like a Badass
for You episode. You touched my breast yesterday. Yeah. She wanted to get him on the tape saying
to
that.
Say it.
Yeah, no, but what did he say? I can't help myself or something?
Yeah, well, he said, I do this all the time. And she said, you do it all the time?
Yeah, that's right. That's right.
You know, I was talking to a fellow yesterday, a friend of ours, and he said something that was really unusual. It hadn't occurred to me, and I don't know if he's right. Nobody has said anything in defense of Harvey Weinstein. And this friend of ours didn't exactly defend him, but he did say, the culture in Hollywood is all about the casting couch. And the women who interacted with him probably knew what they were getting into. As you were saying, Ken, you knew the job was dangerous when you took
it. Well, that means now, that gets into the they're asking for it thing about, you know,
I don't agree with him.
I don't agree with him,
but I was kind of shocked that he would even say it. And actually what he was saying
was,
we were talking about, well, if Harvey goes to trial, it's going to be ugly. And he was saying, I don't know if it will be ugly because people on the jury, regular folks, might think along those lines. You think he's crazy? Do you think
I think he's crazy because I think people do recognize that that's the way that Hollywood works, and that the people, young people, are exploited, and the naive and desperate are exploited. But I think they will take any opportunity to put their foot down and say, whoa, I've got power all of a sudden. I've got a chance to make the world a better place, to change this, fight this system. I'm going to put this guy away. I mean, maybe regardless of the facts, just because it might change things for the better in Hollywood.
Yeah. So before the break, I was saying we were going to shift over to Dianne Feinstein, and, you know, my little clever transition. I was saying, well, there's the one woman in California that Harvey Weinstein hasn't harassed, and you were expressing a dissenting view, O'Connor. You were saying, who knows? I'm assuming facts not in evidence.
Right.
We don't know he hasn't harassed Dianne.
Let's run through the statistics of it. She's female. That's 100% chance of that. We've got how many years she's been on planet Earth, and hours spent in California, interaction with famous people.
That's true.
Senators do it all the time. It's basically 6 degrees of molestation. There's no way she hasn't been approached by Harvey Weinstein.
Maybe we should put her under oath. Here's the deal. I don't know exactly when she came to the Senate, but it was probably about 1990, 1992.
I think it was 92 with Clinton, and wasn't that the same year Clinton was elected president?
In 92 was Clinton, So the news is Dianne Feinstein, at age 84, wants to run for re-election for yet another term in the U.S. Senate, and it's really mixing things up in California Democratic politics. Well, that's a redundancy. There are no Republican politics in California.
Yeah.
Every single constitutional officer in California, from governor, lieutenant governor, treasurer, superintendent of public instruction, everyone is a Democrat. You've got a supermajority, I think, both in the Assembly and the Senate. It's like the Republicans don't exist. So let's just talk about politics.
True.
So a lot of unhappy big wig Democrats who are thinking, hey, time for me to step up and go to the U.S. Senate. Kevin De Leon, he was.
By the way, the author of it is a side issue, real quick, but the sanctuary state thing, which is now, right. Which is law, is it law as
yeah,
of January 1st?
I think the governor signed it.
Is that correct? Yeah, he did sign it.
He signed it. I'm not sure if it was effective immediately or January 1, but it's on the books, yeah.
Yep. So he's going to challenge, I think he's going to challenge her.
Now that's going to be ugly for, no matter how prominent a Democrat in the state, for him to challenge the lion of Democratic politics in California, Dianne Feinstein, after all these years. What, just because she's 84? Because he can't really say that she's incompetent or she's not progressive enough.
Right,
I guess
he might
try that, but that would be a little dangerous.
I mean, it's strangely we're in this transitional period because you're absolutely right that California might as well be a one-party state as much as it is. I mean, it is literally a state, but there are lots of one political party states, like anything from the DPR, like the Democratic People's Republic of North Korea. You've got Japan, you've got China, all of these places. In Japan, for example, it's a democracy, but there is only one, effectively one political party with very few minor interruptions previously. And essentially, two people of the same party run against one another in every election. Now, that might be our future in California. We might have actual contentious elections between Democrats much more frequently at every level if people start to realize at some point that the Republicans have no hope.
I'm thinking that it's so expensive to go through some big bruising fight. Why not just have a cage fight between Dianne Feinstein and Kevin De Leon?
Hello, Vince. Yeah.
I think she could take him.
Vince McMahon.
I want to get Dave Davis back in there. I want to get Arnold Schwarzenegger back in there.
Let's have a mud wrestling contest between the two of them.
Absolutely.
And you know the other big names, Villaraigosa and Gavin Newsom, whether you like it or not, that's what got us same-sex marriage, was that
These
line.
These guys could be WWE characters.
And Garcetti. Yeah, Garcetti was campaigning for the presidency in New Hampshire. He's going to be it'll be a step down for him to become governor of California. Hey, when we come back, we're going to talk about the Las Vegas tragedy. They're changing the timeline on us in a very big way. Stay with us on the Royal Oak Show.
We'll be back on CRN with the Royal Oak Show.
Credit cards are sure fun to use, perhaps a little addicting, and they kind of make you feel rich. Well, if you're like most Americans, you've got over 5 maxed out credit cards in your pocket right now, and you can barely make the minimum payments, right? I'd like to personally recommend a company called DebtHelper.com. DebtHelper.com is a licensed and insured nonprofit debt management agency. They can help cut your interest rates by as much as 50% and lower your monthly payments, saving you thousands of dollars in finance charges on your credit card bills. DebtHelper.com does not lend money. DebtHelper's program could have you paying off your credit card debt in full in a 3 to 5 year period. Call DebtHelper.com right now for your free confidential consultation today. 866-706-3328. 866-706-3328. 866-706-3328.
Credit card management services, Inc. DBA, DebtHelper.com. 3025 North Congress Avenue, number 201, West Palm Beach, Florida, 33401. Non-payment of debt may be creditors to increase finance and other charges or undertake collection activity, including litigation.
When you really want Italian food, you've got to get to Columbo's. Columbo's Italian Steakhouse and Jazz Club. Colorado Boulevard, Eagle Rock. It's that little neighborhood place you wish was down the street from you. Seekers of luscious and appetizing gustatorial pursuits, indulge your fancies with steaks so absolutely yum-yum. Vegetarians have forsaken kale and Pilates and never look back. Fish specialties so fresh and delicious and chosen by King Neptune himself, and relish Columbo's Italian family specialties so delectable you'll be yelling out, bravo, bravo! And let's not forget Columbo's world famous meatballs, and you've got to try their breakfast pizza. Mmm! Oh, and jazz every night. Service that's friendly, not fawning, and at a price that'll keep you coming back. That's Columbo's. That little neighborhood place you wish was down the street from you. Columbo's Mangia.
Welcome back to the Royal Oak Show with our co-host Ken Jeffries, our millennial correspondent Connor Oakes. So, this is a catchy tune. Anybody on the panel have any idea?
What this one's saying? I'll say, it's not the kind of song that you'd hear from the scene in Back to the Future when Marty McFly sees himself transported back to his parents' age.
1916.
So I'll commend 55. It for that.
Okay.
And I actually really like the song, but I still
And it's not Coldplay.
Well, I know half. I know some.
And it's not Green Day.
No, but I got nothing.
Ken, you got an idea?
Yeah, Jay Giles. It is a Jay Giles band, but I can't remember. It's not. I want to say Kodachrome, and it's not. That's Paul Simon did Kodachrome.
Yeah.
But I can't remember the title of it though.
Yeah, you know, I'm blanking on the title as well. Jose, happen to remember?
Centerfold.
There you go.
Well, sounds like Kodachrome, but
that's
it's not.
A good name for a song.
There you go.
I didn't know how to name them back then.
Tribute to Hugh Hefner, I guess.
So, speaking of, before we get to Las Vegas, I guess, so Hugh Hefner's gone, and they're having to hose the place down. So that's, oh my God. Well, you know, they say most of the world's diseases originated in Bob Guccione's hot tub. Fortunately, Connor has never seen Penthouse Magazine.
You know about
so
Bob
he doesn't,
Guccione?
He doesn't know about Guccione. He was the Hugh Hefner of Penthouse Magazine.
Of course.
So anyway, I don't know what's going to happen now to the Playboy Mansion.
Where are people going to find gone. Sexy pictures?
Yeah, I don't know.
Harvey Weinstein might want to rent it out.
It's very possible. Yeah, it's very possible.
Who knows what.
So, okay, the timeline in Vegas is apparently being changed, and you guys may have a better handle on this than I do, but from what I understood, generally, the security guard gets shot in the leg by the maniac at 9:59 or so, and he calls in and he tells people in the hotel immediately. But they don't run up to the floor, the 32nd floor, right away. In fact, they don't get there till about 17 after. They go to some other floors first. And so meantime, the guy starts shooting people about 6 or 7 after, and the whole thing takes about 9 minutes, the slaughter. And so now the sheriff is on the defensive, and people are saying, hey, you know, why didn't you tell us this before? Why is the timeline changing? Ken, I know you're covering this for KBC. What's going on?
I saw the news conference, which was, I guess, yesterday, and it was the sheriff seemed very defensive, very angry. I can just tell you what it was more like what he looked like rather than really what he said, I guess. But he looked very upset. He broke down in tears because he talked about some of the officers who risked their lives, you know, and he said these officers should be talked about in the media. I think that's what he said. But he was just very angry at various interpretations of the timeline and all this other stuff that made, I presume, the Las Vegas Police Department look bad. And
are people raising questions about why it is that if the hotel knew almost instantly that their guy was shot at 9:59 on the floor, why people weren't rushing up to that door Swiss cheese?
I don't know anything about this. I don't know anything about the procedure that anyone should take. But at the same time, was anyone thinking that the guy was planning on spraying automatic weapon fire from a window?
I'm sure
down
they weren't.
On the other hand, the
fact that he's spraying bullets through the door is not exactly
maybe
normal, even for Las Vegas,
you're
right?
I mean, I've seen some movies, but yeah, no, you're right. I mean, it's much more easily explained by the incompetence or hesitance or fear of hotel staff who say something like, well, don't send our security guards running to their deaths on that floor. Evacuate people, isolate exits, and then call the police. Yeah. Now, when they called the police is maybe a different question, and I don't know exactly when that happened or if it happened fast enough.
We have the advantage of 2020 hindsight.
Yeah, exactly.
And that obviously. So, but the other thing, though, and the LA Times ran this as a sidebar story the other day, and kudos to them. It was a very interesting thing about Vegas is a city that prides itself on security.
Yeah.
If you're a card shark.
Right.
However, if you apparently go in there toting guns, they don't know, you know, in suitcases, and of course they don't, but that's another issue. So that's a problem for them. That's a black eye for Vegas.
Yeah, it is.
The big hole in security.
So
they had all these cameras looking down on you know, card tables and stuff like that, and of course they showed that in all the Ocean's 11 movies and stuff, but yeah. You want to bring in a gun to a now? Obviously, you put a gun in a suitcase, or was the guy carrying 11 suitcases in? I heard that
apparently,
he was. I don't
they
know
have a
that.
Record of
they
seeing him
know.
Carry that many cases in.
Yeah, they didn't see obviously that they were guns.
If you're thinking, I'm a Vegas potential Vegas high roller who's going to risk tens or hundreds or thousands of dollars or I don't know millions of dollars, and maybe now you're thinking all this casino security in Vegas is there for the casino's protection and not so much for my protection.
Right.
And I don't feel as secure bringing all this cash into this hotel.
Well, the other timeline issue, apparently there was some confusion about when the guy was even checking in. There was a three-day difference, the 28th or the 25th.
Yeah, major black eye.
How can that be up in the air? I mean, by now, shouldn't they have resolved that? And then I think Ken, maybe you were saying Steve Wynn was weighing in.
I read something where Steve Wynn made a comment about something like it wouldn't happen in one of my hotels,
right?
And so
maybe he's got a better.
How do you know?
That's. I mean, obviously that's nonsense. But maybe he's got some view where he hears some bad. Maybe he hears about the timeline discrepancies, and he hears about the check-in time differences, and he hears about the unarmed security guard going in alone, or whatever else. And he said that small aspect. Maybe he's saying that. Not that I'm trying to defend the guy's seemingly ridiculous and probably kind of insensitive comment, but maybe he's coming from a place of defensiveness because all of Vegas is on the defensive.
Well, you know, Connor, I know your attitude was, look, let's not rush into a discussion of gun control. Let's let things settle down for a little while.
Lord.
You think now, maybe by now we should be talking about,
finally,
Connor, talk about beefing up the gun rules?
Yeah.
You know, it's funny, for all the talk in the first few days, I haven't really picked up on much ongoing debate.
Once again, it lasts 2 days, and then everyone wants to move on.
Well, the NRA, they're getting rid of the bump stocks. Hey, when we come back, as I mentioned before, we're going to inaugurate a new feature, the Moron of the Month feature on the Royal Oak Show. We're going to have this week's nomination, so stay with us.
We'll be back on CRN with the Royal Oak Show.
Come to Angelo's and Vinci's to see the memorabilia of movie stars and theatrical magic right in downtown Fullerton, California. See the Art of the Masters, an Italian town square complete with storefronts of old Italian butchers and cheesemongers, fruit and wine vendors, seamstresses showing their wares, fairy lights from cathedral ceilings, and our ancestors smiling down at you from the family love altar. The Romance of Romeo and Juliet, and find the mystical Room of the Moon. And don't forget King Kong, Dracula, Frankenstein, and who knows what awaits you in the wine cellar. Enjoy the great food. We hand-stuff our pastas, roll each and every tortellini, bake our own bread, make our own sauces fresh from our private stock of Sicilian family recipes. From pasta to seafood, chicken to award-winning pizzas, tiramisu flown in from Rome. If you can't find something on our menu to tempt you, you don't like Italian food. Try our Sunday brunch, just $18.95, and Angelo's and Vinci's has been named 2 years in a row Best Italian Restaurant in Orange County. Angelo's and Vinci's Restaurant, 550 North Harbor Boulevard in Fullerton, California. Call 714-879-4020.
If you're eligible for Medicare, you need to know there is money available to you that can lower your Medicare prescription costs. How much can you save? Find out now by making a free call to Health Markets. They'll search from a variety of nationally recognized plans to find you the right coverage at a price that fits your budget. And they'll do all this valuable research for you at no charge to you. And remember, you may be able to save money on your prescriptions. We'll tell you if you qualify. Why pay a penny more than you have to for an insurance policy? Let us find you the right plan at the right price and see if you qualify to lower your prescription costs. Put our free service to work for you at no charge. Call Health Markets right now.
800-990-0351. 800-990-0351. 800-990-0351. That's 800-990-0351.
Health Markets Insurance Agency is the DBA of InSphere Insurance Solutions, Inc. Licensed in all 50 states and DC. Service and product availability varies by state. Agents may be compensated based on your enrollment.
What are you going to do with your old car? You can try selling it, you could junk it, or you could donate it to Heritage for the Blind. Your car will be towed away for free, and your donation is tax deductible. Just call 1-800-785-9618. Heritage for the Blind accepts cars, vans, trucks, and boats. It doesn't matter if your vehicle runs or not. It will be towed away for free, and you'll be supporting those that need help. Heritage for the Blind is a nonprofit organization that helps the visually impaired live fuller lives. Call right now to donate your car, and as a special thank you for calling, you'll receive a free 3-day vacation voucher to many exciting locations. Call Heritage for the Blind right now, 1-800-785-9618. Donating is easy, and your vehicle is towed away for free. Plus, you'll get a free vacation voucher. Call now, 1-800-785-9618. That's 1-800-785-9618.
Clearing skies and drying eyes, now I see.
Welcome back to the Royal Oak Show. And once again, this is millennial-oriented music, but it's beautiful music.
Soothing.
It's soothing. It's even putting Ken Jeffries to sleep.
It's allowing me to forget for a moment about Trump.
So half of Simon and Garfunkel is doing this thing. And I'll give you a hint. It ain't Paul Simon.
Oh,
it's
well,
it's our Garfunkel.
Then it's
Disney Girls.
Disney Girls?
Yeah, it's an ethereal voice this guy has. Yeah, it's a wonderful singer.
What does Disney Girls mean?
Well, you're going to have to look it up on the internet.
And that's Funicello, I think.
Yeah, it's like Disney princesses?
Yeah, kind of like that.
Oh,
yeah,
it's like the Frozen or whatever those things are.
So
Ariel or
the moron of the month on the Royal Oak shows is what I want to inaugurate here. I got the idea because there was a Florida professor a month or so ago, just a
Florida man,
brain surgeon, who said, well, I think the people of Houston had all that horrible hurricane damage because they voted for Trump.
Of course. It's sort of like the Christian pastor saying that there's an earthquake because of the gays or Obama.
And so now here's this month's nominee. His name is George Ciccarello Marr. He's a Drexel University professor.
Okay.
And he thinks that the Las Vegas shooting is a result of white supremacist patriarchy. Okay. He blamed the horrible shooting on white people in general, saying they've been entitled to everything and shootings like this happen when they don't get it. He went on to say his attitude is tied to the idea of white victimhood, which he believes is the spinal column of Trumpism. He had some tweets along the lines of, all I want for Christmas is white genocide. He's white, by the way.
Right.
So I think this is my nominee for moron of the month.
I mean, obviously, when you say something like all you want is genocide, you're a moron, right? Mm-hmm. Even though it's clearly...
I think the rest of the stuff he said is he
singing, I'm dreaming of a white genocide? Is that...
he's blaming the Las Vegas shooting on white entitlement.
What he's doing is trying to point out that white supremacists who are literally touting and saying, we are undergoing a genocide. Look up the dictionary definition of genocide. It includes being displaced from public office and having people intermarry into your race. That counts as genocide, which is nonsense, crazy talk. And so he's lampooning that, but he does come off like a moron, yes. Now, is this shooting a result of white people not getting what they feel like they deserve and then reacting badly? No, I'm going to vote against that.
Yeah.
Is white supremacy an issue? Yes. No, but is this the way to approach it? No.
There are other nominees. There's Representative Mark Walker. He's chair of the Conservative Republican Study Committee. He described female members of the Republican Committee as the committee's eye candy. That didn't go over well. He was sorry. He said, during a press event today, I made a flippant remark meant to be lighthearted but fell short. I'm proud of the women who serve in our RSC leadership. But the gals are hot, he reiterated.
I'm proud. Like, why do you have the stat? Why do you get to say you're proud of them? I'm so proud of these girls. They rose right up through the Girl Scouts, and now they're just, don't look how well.
And now they
doing.
May become Boy Scouts. That's another story with the Boy Scouts. Another issue, too, the Boy Scouts and the Girl Scouts.
By the way, Representative Mark Walker is also a pastor, in addition to being a member
of Congress. So he's a sensitive guy who understands the impact of his words.
You know, we live in a politically correct world, guys. You just can't say nice things about people. You can't say stupid nice things about people. Well, I can tell you from working in an office these many years, things have changed. You literally cannot say without getting into trouble or second guessing yourself anything nice about anybody's appearance. Used to be just
that's
women.
True. I mean, yeah, you don't want
you,
yeah, that
you
is,
can't
that's...
comment on somebody's hair or their dress or anything. And so that's just the world we're living in. Hey, ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for joining us once again.
You guys look nice, by the way.
Oh, well.
Okay,
well
I need to
find out to say it.
We do our best.
Where's the HR department?
So glad glad you made the show, Connor. Connor made it with 15 seconds to spare. Ken Jeffries, thank you for the fabulous job as co-host, as always.
Thank you, Jose, Engineer Jose.
Absolutely. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll see you next week on the Royal Oak Show. Have a great week.
Which was most appropriate because that was your theme.
Are you tired of hearing your favorite talk radio show sound like this? What if you could hear your favorite shows in crystal clear, high-definition digital sound? Well, with CRN Digital Talk Radio's 6 channels of high-definition radio, you can now hear all of your favorite hosts like you've never heard them before in CRN HD. The difference is amazing.
Catch your favorite political hosts like Dennis.